Basically, this is the result of the chest position. That's the EQ. That's what you get from placing the microphone on the chest. If you then make a mirror of that position, mirror it over this axis here, and make the opposite. There we go. If you make that EQ, then you have compensated for the position. You have compensated for the bad placement. This is just a rule of thumb. You obviously you have to use your own ears because it could be a little individual from person to person. But as a rule of thumb, this is basically what happens, or this is what you should be doing to get back to the flat frequency response, which is basically or partly answer to your question is why is it a good idea to have a flat frequency response? Because if you don't have a flat frequency response to begin with, you don't know what to pull. You don't know where to work because you have lost your hearing in just 4 seconds, and it's kind of hard to compensate for something that you cannot see or you cannot hear. So if you know that the microphone is flat, you know that the position is bad, you can start compensating. You can start creating the correct sound afterwards. On some of these small mics, there are a little high boost and a soft boost grill that will acoustically change the frequency response of the microphone. It works like this. If you put a tube in front of the microphone, you will have a boost in a certain frequency. That's good for when you are, if you're underneath clothing, you get that high boost, you get that little extra high boost, or a lot extra actually. One thing that we often hear when we are looking at this frequency response here, that one, the chest response, is that it is chest sound. It is sound coming from the chest. We hear that a lot from very good sound engineers. We have chest sound, they call it. And a lot of people, they think that it is the sound of the chest. But that's not true. There is no sound coming from the chest. The chest sound is a product of the placement and the microphone being placed on a surface. You see, on all of these, we have this little peak here around 800 hertz. That little peak comes from the microphone being now placed on a surface, being the human body. So the microphone is now a boundary layer microphone. It's a PZM microphone. When you place a microphone on a surface, it will increase certain frequencies. If you place it on a stage floor, it will increase all frequencies. But if you place it on something small, like the head or the chest, it will be a limited part of the frequency range. On the human body, it's 800 hertz. If it was sound coming from the chest that created that sound, why would we then have the peak on all the other positions? So this just proves that there are no sound coming from the chest. We have two sound sources on the human body. One is in this area, and the other one, it's not the chest. So let's kill that myth too. There's not such thing as chest sound. There is a product of the microphone being placed on the chest that creates that sound.